you first see a reflection of the sunlight against the buildings on the north side of the street. Those buildings, steel and glass, will reflect the sun. You say, the sun is coming, it's coming, it's coming. And then the sun enters the frame. That bit of anticipation is always a delight, at least for me.
Manhattanhenge is a name that we've given to the days of the year when the sun sets perfectly aligned with the grid of Manhattan. I think Manhattanhenge is really a reminder that we live on this spinning rock that's also moving around the sun in an orbit. We have arrived at this position where you could stand in the middle of this great gridded city, take your finger and point it down the middle of 42nd Street, and a line would extend from your arm all the way out 93 million miles to intersect the exact position that the sun is in that moment. Manhattanhenge is really astronomy in your face.
If you ask yourself, where does the sun rise each day? Most people say, oh, it rises in the east and sets in the west. If they give you that answer, it means they've never really paid attention to what's going on. Because the rising point of the sun and the setting point of the sun changes daily. What that means is, you can ask yourself, on what day does the sun set aligned with this grid?
So I am the official calculator of Manhattanhenge. Every year I do the calculation for the American Museum of Natural History, and we officially put out the dates and the times for the world. I will look very carefully at the position of the sun and the exact coordinates of the Manhattan grid.
Generally, when you try to identify a place in the sky from where you're standing, you would give its azimuth. That's its point along the horizon, and then you'd give its elevation above the horizon. And those two numbers uniquely place an object on the sky where you're standing. If you look at a map of Manhattan, we think uptown is north and downtown is south, and that's fine. No one will fault you for that. But if you really looked it up, the borough of Manhattan is actually rotated east of north by about 30 degrees.
It's not exactly north-south. So you can't use that as your azimuth direction. So Neil deGrasse Tyson went outside and did a measurement of the grid of Manhattan. I went outside and did a measurement of the grid of Manhattan. And we came to the consensus that 299.1 degrees is our chosen azimuth, and half a degree or a quarter of a degree in terms of its altitude. The altitude can vary depending on where you are in the city, but I always do the calculation for 42nd Street at Fifth Avenue. Manhattanhenge happens officially four times a year. One is when the very, very bottom of the sun kisses the grid right before it goes below the horizon. And that's what we call full Manhattanhenge. Then we have a second kind of event, which is when the midpoint of the sun kisses the grid before it goes below the horizon, and we call that half sun. You have May 28th and 29th for the half sun on the grid, and then the full sun on the grid. And then on the other side of the summer solstice, you have the reverse of that. You have full sun on the grid on July 11th, and then half sun on the grid on July 12th. There is a similar phenomenon for sunrise. It will happen about 6 months later because now you have to wait for the Earth to get all the way around to the other side in its orbit.
Here's the problem. Looking east for a sunrise, Manhattan ascends. So from many vantage points looking due east, you don't actually see the horizon itself. It's just not as interesting. It's not as striking. Plus, nobody wants to wake up that early. There would be an equivalent Manhattanhenge for the moon. That would be a setting full moon. But a full moon is full because it is exactly opposite the sun. So you'd be watching a Manhattanhenge just before sunrise, as the full moon, being opposite in the sky, dips below the horizon. No one stops their car to get out and watch the moon set. It's not a thing. It's not so radiant as the sun is. to give you that sparkly, photogenic cosmic moment. Nothing would be as striking as Manhattanhenge with the sun. So my first photo of Manhattanhenge, I stood in the middle of Park Avenue on 34th Street. What you get is a fascinating vanishing point with all the buildings of steel and glass framing it. This is what makes it a henge. Stonehenge has vertical stones that, depending on where you look and how they align, they will configure with the sun, moon, and stars.
Sunsets and sunrises are parts of the day that we should all prioritize anyway. And on the dates of Manhattanhenge, the city comes alive to watch it. People stop on the streets. They ask each other what's going on. They get annoyed, but then they get happy.
New Yorkers hardly ever look up. I think to the extent that we do not look up, we are losing something fundamental to what it is to be alive on Earth, planet Earth, and to have the mental capability to contemplate the cosmos itself. You're missing out.